Today, we are going to learn one of the essential skills in 360 video post-production, video denoising. 9 out of 10, you are using a VR camera with a small sensor that does not do so good in low-light situation. Sometimes, you even have flickers because of wrong camera setting while you are filming in other countries. I will show you my workflow to minimize compression artifacts, which is one of the main reasons why these cameras are so noisy. And I will show you my secret weapon, which is Neat Video version 5, to remove unwanted noise and add sharpness back in post-production. By the end of this video, you will have the professional knowledge to fix all your noise-related problems so you can be confident to film VR in any lighting situation. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, your free online film school for professional 360 VR production. If you want to up your game in VR, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell. So you ask, why my 360 footage is so noisy? Considering you just spent more than $5,000 on a professional VR camera like the Insta360 Pro 2, Candle Obsidian or Zcam S1 Pro. If you own one of these consumer cameras right here and want to use free capture for 2D footage and having a tough time to match your DSLR because too noisy and too much compression artifacts, you are not alone. All this VR camera right here use small sensor and have a poor dynamic range with heavy compression. To be efficient, which saves storage space with the expense of noise. Why getting big sensor low compression VR camera is close to impossible at the current market unless you are rich. You can still clear up your footage in post-production and make them look professional. Okay, let's talk about the denoiser we are going to use, which is Neat Video version 5. Just released last week, which dramatically increased the performance speed with GPU acceleration. Neat Video is actually not only for VR. Lots of 2D videographers already know and using it daily on their 2D low-light production. In the newly released version 5, it works great with footage has heavy digital compression. One common thing I noticed in all major brand VR cameras is jitter in details. Don't believe me? Zoom in and look at your Insta360 ONE X footage. And Neat Video 5 help you to remove exactly that. It also has video deflicker now to help you to remove those flickering as commonly see in VR camera or just wrong camera setting. Tips: if you're filming VR in different country, please check the live fixture refresh rate and adjust your camera accordingly if you plan to only use practical lighting. But sometimes for cameras like Candle Obsidian, you don't want to shoot 25 frames per second in Europe. It does not work in VR headset. You need 30 frames per second and just deal with the flicker in post. Luckily, Neat Video version 5 can fix that as well. Okay, the workflow. Before we jump into the denoiser, there are steps that are very, very important to help remove unnecessary compression. There are usually three levels of transcoding happen in your pipeline. The capture stage, from your camera to your storage devices, which you generally have no controls. Almost all of them are H.264 or H.265. Then you need to stitch them together. And finally, you need to render them again in H.264 or 5 for VR headset, which you have no control. So the only level you can control is stitching. The reason why I stitch everything with Mystica VR using ProRes or even PNG sequence is to remove this extra level of compression. For Insta360 Pro 2, you can use the Insta360 stitcher to export ProRes as well. So please do that. Don't compress it again into another level of H.264. For consumer camera like the GoPro Fusion or Views XR right here, they both have uncompressed codecs like Cineform or Apple ProRes. So use that. For Insta360 ONE X, well, you're out of luck unless you have Mystica VR. After you stitch with an uncompressed codec or image sequence, now open up your editing software. We use Adobe Premiere here, but Neat Video also supports DaVinci Resolve, Final Cut Pro X, or your editing software of choice. For those of you who use DaVinci Resolve, they also have very, very powerful temporal denoiser. So try it first before jump into Neat Video. So right here, we have a drone footage captured by the Insta360 ONE X in 6 a.m. in the morning in Sheffield, England. As you see, the sun is not up yet, so it's considered as a low light situation. If you zoom in to the footage right here, look at the building right here, you see another moving noise, and it's actually easier to see. If you look at the parking lot structure right here, you see a lot of moving, jittering noise right here. So here is the after denoise result, so we can see a before and after comparison of the denoiser. Okay, let me show you my workflow. So step one is go ahead and after you install Neat Video, go into effects panel, type in Neat, and you find a reduce noise V5, drop it over on top of your footage, and then go ahead into effect control right here, the effects, go ahead and hit prepare, and then open build to open Neat Videos to build a noise profile. So now we are inside Neat Video interface. If you hover the mouse, you see all different pop-up area into this divided three grab right here. And all this little weird stuff is noise. Well, first step is I gotta let Neat Video to help me to build an auto profile. So I go ahead, hit auto profiling. And that Neat Video find the sky and then the noise level is 0.08. In general scenario for low light footage, especially for drone footage, sky is actually is a great place to find noise profile because it's a featureless sky. But in for this particular footage, I think it's so noisy and the sky is so featureless, we don't really capture the real noise I want to remove in this particular footage. I actually want to go into the parking structure right here. And I want this parking structure have no noise because it's a solid ground, it should not have any noise. And now we have noise and color noise and jittery in the parking structure. So I go ahead and manually pick an area in the parking lot. They have this non-uniform air and CR layer right here. I think it's okay because this really captured the noise profile on this entire footage. In general scenario, you try to avoid this. But for this particular footage, it's okay because we know that the parking lot structure, the ground is not perfectly smooth as well. So go ahead and hit the build profile. And again, warning message, the area is too small. Ideal scenario, you want to find a bigger area with a green around it. But again, in this footage, we don't have the luxury to do that. So we're just going to use this small area. So now go ahead and check the profile check button. And this is the result of removing the noise. As you see, all three graphs got a pretty impressive denoising result already, including this footage right here. So now I'm happy about the noise profile. I go ahead and move on to adjust and preview tab. The next step, I will hit on filter setting check right here. Go on noise level check to make sure blue cover all the static area of the entire frame. So go ahead and finish 2, 3, and 4. We go through that when we go to the next tutorial. I will teach you how to deflicker the footage. And then the next thing I will do, it will open up the jitter of detail and just bump this up to around like 20. I found out 20 is the best setting to handling Insta360 ONE X footage. And that's it. That's all I do. I actually don't touch spatial denoiser unless the footage is really noisy and in really low light scenario. for most of the 1x footage, that would be perfect. Go ahead and hit the General tab. Just make sure in the preference you are using CPU plus GPU. One thing I did not do here in the Spatial tab is enable sharpening. In 2D workflow, you usually actually use this to bring back the sharpness so the footage is not so blurry. But if you're using a neat video sharpening feature, that is not a 360 aware feature, will create a seam line on the edges. So I never use the sharpening feature inside neat video. I only use neat video for denoising. That's it. And that's it. Go ahead and hit apply. And then what I will suggest is go ahead and render your denoiser footage. Because again, we got MP4 from the 1X stitcher, and I usually transcode that into ProRes to just increase the workflow. And also, when you have a denoiser on top, your whole preview is impossible. So I will usually just go ahead and render that out into QuickTime Apple ProRes, and then we'll bring the footage back and continue my edit. So denoising is actually step one before I even do color correction and sharpening. So as I said, after denoise, you need to sharpen. There are two options to add sharpening. The pro version I would suggest is using Boris effects. Using Boris effect VR sharpening right here. But since that's not free anymore and most people don't have that, we'll just use the Premiere stock sharpening feature right under immersive video, VR sharpen. Just go ahead and drop that in the footage. And then just bump back the sharpener into the frame. As you see, immediately it looks a lot sharper and better. And again, VR sharpening is not sharpening the noise anymore because the footage has no noise in it, and only sharpen the feature you wanted. So the footage actually looked better. And that's it. Now you can go ahead and add some color correction on there. And go ahead and drop in a lumetri color. Turn on VR mode. Voila! We got a really nice looking drone footage without noise. Let's take a look at a more professional scenario. This is one of my upcoming VR release with Mark Christopher Lawrence, a famous actor and comedian. This comedy VR special is captured in a very dark comedy club with the Insta360 Pro 2 in 8K by 8K stereoscopic 3D 360 with ambisonic audios to bring the audience onto the front row of Mark's performance. Insta360 Pro 2 is a great camera, but it does not do so well in such an extreme low-light scenario. We need to remove lots of sensor noise in post-production. Before we dive right in neat video, it is recommended to denoise individual clips before stitching to get the best performance, as 8K by 8K is going to be tough for most of the machine, even with GPU acceleration. Since you need Mystical VR to do that, which not many of my viewers have, we instead using the Insta360 Stitcher to generate a ProRes 422 Stitch MOV file here to work on the 8K by 8K directly in Premiere. If you drop neat video or any plugins require GPU acceleration after any Adobe native immersive video plugins, like here, the VR Rotate Sphere, you will get the error message. The effects require GPU acceleration. Don't worry, just make sure to move any third-party plugins before immersive video plugins. The problem will be solved. Now we are in neat video. Step one is if you are in beginner mode, make sure you switch to advanced mode. And then same idea, go ahead and hit the auto profiling. And that video figure out the noise level, but it's not that great. It picked the ceiling right here. And as I know, I want to make the carpet area become featureless and no noise. And it should be, so I'll go ahead and select big area. So I found a good area big enough with the green border with decent noise level. Then I go ahead and hit build profile and pay attention on these three graph. And as you see, neat video and doing really great job to remove most of the noise in all the three area. If it does not, go ahead and bump up the noise level right here until it doesn't see any noise inside the box. And then you can go ahead and jump into adjust for preview. For Pro 2 footage, I will go ahead and bump the radius into 3. So basically log 3 frame before the current frame and 3 frame after the current frame to decide where is the noisy area to remove noise. And I will also go to the spatial denoiser and go ahead to increase some luminance denoising and noise level right here. I will play around these two sliders until I get a satisfying result for my final frame, and then you can go ahead and hit apply. And then you can follow the exact same workflow you saw earlier on the ONE X to finish your footage. In the next tutorial, I will teach you how to solve a different problem commonly found in consumer and professional VR cameras, flickers. We will take a look at a whole frame flicker in the Insta360 ONE X and how to solve it, and also a more professional setup with the Kendall Obsidian Art with a partial flicker in the frame. We will apply techniques like rotoscoping to get the best result for professional VR footage. Thank you for watching another in-depth 360 post-production tutorial. If you learned something today, don't forget to share with your fellow VR filmmakers, because sharing is loving. And that is what I'm doing right here. You don't need to go to a film school or spend money on courses on some e-learning website to get better in 360 filmmaking. The best learning comes from your friends. And I hope I am one of your friends. And I hope you also comment below and teach me and others your neat trick in VR filmmaking. I want to hear and learn from you as well. Oh, while you're at it, hit the like button so your boy Hugh can continue making more tutorials like this for you. And I will see you next time. Keep creating in VR.